Thank you, Peter. Well, some network stations haven't seen our plays of the month. We have a bit of fun with these edited highlights of the various plays during a particular month. Later on, we'll be looking at last month, but let's take you back to the plays of the month for April.
Calling Tony Antrobus. Tony, could we please begin the plays of the month with the most helpful spectator of April? Hey, Rod, if you want the ball, then why not go and get it yourself? West Coast Eagles Guy McKenna decided that he would rather pass his boot instead of the ball to Troy Ugel. Now, which one of these is lost? Excuse me, Constable, but I think that your horse is over there. Richmond's Michael Mitchell displayed his unique, if not unusual, football talents in April, firstly with this excellent soccer header, and then by executing this extraordinary rugby flick pass. Potato farmer Danny Frawley spent most of the month demonstrating just how he plants his crops, while Melbourne's Brian Wilson once again demonstrated his remarkable acting talents. The most forgettable kick-out of the month belonged to John Manton. Oh, John, this error resulted in a free kick and a goal to Hawthorn's Jason Dunstall. April produced some great aerial work, as proved by St Kilda wizard Nicky Winmar. Hawks spearhead Jason Dunstall also pulled down a big grab, as did Tiger big man David Honeybun at the MCG. However, great marks weren't just taken by the players. Check out this chest mark taken at the whacker by this spectator. Now that's how you do it, Shane. Not to be outdone, even the field umpire at the SCG got into the act. But coach Cole Kinnear was not impressed and was quick to put the man in white in his place. Tiger Dale Waitman was on the wrong end of this shirt front, courtesy of Merv Neagle. While over at Fitzroy, they still haven't learnt who the opposition is. To the goal of the month, and Richmond's Peter Wilson receives the hand pass from Justin Pickering on centre wing and then takes one, two, three, four bounces, crosses the 50-metre line and kicks a great team-lifting goal. And finally, we turn to the most unusual incident of April. It happened at Windy Hill when the field umpire was accidentally felled while trying to stop a melee. You know, it's amazing what some people will do just to make the plays of the month. Don't you agree, sir? Sir?
Sandy Roberts taking a quizzical look at football the way we've seen it in 1989. And later on this afternoon, we'll be taking a look at plays of the month for the month of May.